Look, in voting over the weekend to support the admission of Palestine to the United Nations, the Albanese government is rewarding terrorism and breaking almost eight decades of settled bipartisan support for Israel. It was, after all, Labor's greatest Prime Minister Bob Hawke who declared that if the bell tolls for Israel, it tolls for all mankind. On October 7, it did indeed toll. If the Australian government's ultimate response to this barbarity has been to favour a terrorist statelet of the only liberal democracy in the Middle East. In voting yes, notwithstanding opposition from the US and the UK's abstention, the Albanese government claimed to be upholding Australia's long-standing support for a two-state solution. But this was always predicated on the Palestinians accepting Israel's right to exist behind secure borders, something that no Palestinian leader has ever really done, and which is now implacably opposed by the dominant Hamas faction that is, and let's never forget this, a designated terrorist organisation in Australia and in much of the Western world. The federal government's dramatic departure from all previous practice shows, first, that Anthony Albanese has hardly grown up from the student radical who marched for Palestine 40 years or so ago. Even when he entered the parliament, he kept up his activism.
The response of Israel has been to meet children throwing rocks with helicopter gunships, with tanks and with missiles.
Second, that the dominant intellectual force in this government is Penny Wong, hence its weak on China and soft on national security more generally. And third, that Labor is terrified of the electoral potential of the Muslim vote, which in some key Labor seats is as high as 30% plus. And because activist Muslims support the Greens as the most anti-Israel party, Labor's getting closer to the Greens on both national security and on economics to claw these votes back, which is bad for Australia, but horrific for anyone who believes government should never turn a blind eye to terrorism.